Shell American Bandstand in 1954. The Elbridge Lake is a permanent part of music history in recording Albert King's Bandstand Boogie for a legendary television show hosted by Bob Horn and 2 years later by Dick Clark. I think he's still there doing it now. I'm not sure. But in 1956, Clark took the show from its original broadcast in Philadelphia to ABC TV for national distribution as American Bandstand. He remained host for another 32 years and looked exactly the same when he quit as when he started. Variations of the original song surfaced as the show's theme in later years. Here it is, Les and Larry.
Thank you.
work background and how they live. It's been reported by numerous male and female voters over the sanctuary of this land. Most notably by Jack Jones in 1963. That recording turned in 1964 Grammy Award winning Best Vocal Performance Male and peaked at number 14 on the Hot 100 and number 9 on the Internet Listening Chart. Talk about politically correct, though. Anybody that tried to assume this today would be booed out of the auditorium.
Thank you.
with Al Johnson, former frontman of the Jazz Singer. The song was recorded for all of the major and black star labels of the time. A version was recorded by Leonard Goodman and his orchestra in 1935, and 1946 was also a notable year for the song, with Bing Crosby and Fred Astaire filmed taking its title song, along with recorded versions by Count Basie and Leonard Goodman, which charts respectively. Bing Crosby and Bing came for a long song in 1954, a little bit of Christmas, crossing the genres. Billy Nelson recorded it as an important country music in 1970. It was a major western swing and country song already in 1939, when it was performed on Moon and Mulder. We have quite a list of people to put up to. Here we go, Blue Skies.
wait, they're looking.
Okay, does that work?
I know who I am too, but you know, I'm not sure all these guys know who they are.
All right, we're going to do A Day in the Life of the Pool, written by Brazilian composer Luis Bonfa and lyricist Antonio Maria. It appeared as a principal theme in the 1959 Portuguese language film, or Holy Girl, by French director Marcel Camus. A Day in the Life of a Pool became one of the first bossa compositions to be very popular in Southern Brazil. Particularly in the United States, the song is considered one of the most important Brazilian bossa songs that helped establish the bossa nova movement in the 1950s. I'm going to try and get them to calm down a little bit so I can tell you all the words I'm looking for here.
Ms. Carmen, you're